first area that I want to address this morning is the area of publications. And the reason is that you may have recently received the final version of a publication called Vitreous and Vision Degrading Myodysopsia. This is a 41-page double-columned article with three dozen figures and videos and over 400 references that was published in a journal called Progress in Retinal and Eye Research. The importance of this publication cannot be overstated. The first reason is that vitreous in general has been overlooked. And that is the reason we understand less about vitreous than perhaps any other part of the eye. I often quip by saying that people tend to look through vitreous rather than look at vitreous. And so much of the work that I've done over the last three, four decades has been to directly focus one's attention on vitreous and consider its role in health and disease. And in fact, that's the title of the book that we published in 2014, which was 925 pages long. That's really a large book on something that people tend to overlook and not consider. But the point was that it's actually very important in terms of the health of the eye and in terms of diseases that develop, vision degrading myodysopsia being one of those diseases. So the publication of the recent article is important because that particular journal is the number one impact factor journal in the world. It's a journal of review articles that are by invitation only. And so to be invited to write an article on vitreous demonstrates an increased appreciation for vitreous amongst the leaders in the field. That's very good. To then have the title of the article include the term vision degrading myodysopsia, I believe is a major step forward, because it means that at the very highest level of academic medicine in ophthalmology, that term is now accepted. And it starts to do what we set out to achieve, which is bring to people's awareness the importance of vitreous, and in particular, when you have opacities in the vitreous, the existence of a disease called vision degrading myodysopsia. So for that to be in print in the top journal in the world is a major milestone. And I realize that a lot of the technical aspects of the article may be beyond your understanding or appreciation, but I present it to you because it should show you that there's a tremendous foundation in science to everything that we're talking about and everything that we're working on. And that the concept of floaters of the past needs to be replaced by our current concept, which is based on the molecular biology and the pathology that we recognize. But also, the article points out needs for future research and avenues that can be pursued. So I'm really very pleased to have finally produced a corrected version of that article and for it to be out in the world. And I made it available to you to disseminate to doctors and agencies and various organizations and leaders throughout the world, because it validates what you're concerned about. When you get confronted with ignorance or insensitivity or lack of appreciation for what you're talking about, you can present this article as a summary of the world's literature, as a summary of the understanding that we have in 2020 with respect to vitreous and vision degrading myodysopsia. And it'll help to break down the barriers.